Right. So our setting is on, and this is the other side to which is attached the media, and we'd like to keep it only at 2 cc with all the air bubbles out. So the way we do it is, can I have the ultrasound and this as a PIP, please? At a 50-50, both images need to be equally large. So again, as Parul is again and again pointing to the vessel, I'm going to be sure that that's the follicle. Yes, definitely, this is the one. So first, I'll go into the follicle. I'll aspirate it, the tube which will collect. I'd like you to show the tube as well. And then I'd like you to show the injection. This has a PIP. So this is the needle going. And my aspiration pump has started. And I've emptied the follicle. Sorry, I think it just went off. Yeah, sorry. Ideally, you should just now push the...
After stopping the suction.
Yeah.
And then...
just push the fluid, please.
Fluid. At that... after.
At the same point, without withdrawing the needle.
Yeah, without withdrawing.
So there's some fluid that's come up. That's it. And it's 2 ml. It's supposed to refill the follicle. Try to show you in another follicle. And then you... suck back the same fluid so that if the follicle is stuck at the periphery, if the egg is stuck at the periphery of the follicle, it's washed out completely. So then the tube goes back again to the lab. Let me try to show you in this one as well.
Hi, Kaveri, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Hi, Nina here. Kaveri, I just want to ask, you using what fluid to push in as for flushing? Is it ringers or you would prefer some kind of a media?
No, it's media.
It's media.
Yeah. It's flushing media.
Flushing media.
Can I have the view bigger, please? Yeah, sorry.
And would you wait until you hear from your embryologist or the egg, or you would sort of, for the sake of demonstration, you're showing this as a this thing?
Yeah, ideally we'd like to wait. So this is the follicle again. Going in. Aspirating completely, then pushing saline, push please, stop, should not be more than 1 to 2 mm and re-aspirate. So this is our flushing dual egg aspiration is done.
Once to ensure that the follicle doesn't stick to the walls of the follicle cavity, what exactly do you do in a single lumen? I mean, to ensure that it doesn't get stuck to the wall, what precautions do you take?
Yeah, that's a very good question. I think you learn that as you progress. Come kar do view. What I do is I slowly withdraw the needle as the aspiration is going on, even inside a follicle.
Yeah, absolutely.
And once we've reached, say, 1/3 of the follicle, then I try to rotate the tip to
of
be sure. Yeah, slightly.
Absolutely. I think it's a very good comment you've made, because it's like calling, it's called the curating the follicle, as they say.
Yes,
to curate it of all the, you know, oocytes there.
Yeah.
I think it's a very good suggestion.
So once... So once the pickup is done, I'm going to check both the ovaries to be sure that I've not left any hidden follicle anywhere. If you see any follicle that's less than 12 mm, please don't bother going into it with a needle. In all possibility, it's going to be an immature egg and not lead to any fertilization, and you're going to put extra, it can have a side effect of puncture, etc. So less than 12 mm, you can leave.
And what about these hematoma, kind of the whitish shadows that you leave behind once you do the ovum pickup, Kaveri?
Yeah, yeah. So this...
Do they worry you or, what is your take on that?
Yeah, not at all, not at all. So they will happen. So once you have taken out the fluid from your follicles, there would be blood vessels that would ooze, the capillaries would ooze, and it would show as these collections. It is an indicator that you've gone to the follicle properly and done your aspiration well. And they all resolve on their own within 2 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks, they're all out. So we should not get too worried about these collections, and they resolve on their own.
And do you find the follicles filling back again once you do a, you know, ultrasound 7 days later, or maybe, you know, 14 days later? Have you seen the follicles refilling back?
Yeah, the size may increase, the size may, but in most cases the answer is no.
No, with the hypostimulation, with patients of polycystic having more, very many
yes.
follicles, you can see them all
yes.
coming back.
Yes,
actually.
Definitely with hypostimulation, yes. That's the whole gamut altogether. I will move on,
yeah.
And I'm just going to close this and going to show an important part, and which is the being sure of the hemostasis, and that's very, very important. Have the speculum. So once you've done your pickup, can I have the camera in here, please? So as you see, it's pretty dry. There's no collection,
mm-hmm.
nothing. Sometimes you'll see, I'm afraid it's not very clear. If you can just push it back a little bit for a clearer view.
We can see that.
Yeah.
Mm.
So that's it really. And then once I've checked, even if there are bleeding spots, can I have it back here? All I'm going to do is take a small shoulder and put in a gauze piece and just push at the bleeder. There can be small spots that ooze, and you just need to push it for a minute or 2 minutes by the clock, and they will get controlled. You don't have to panic at all. So by God's grace, we've had no case where we needed to stitch or do anything. Yes, we've had cases of bled significantly, but just by identifying the right spot and putting in your gauze piece and pressing it hard enough leads to good hemostasis, and that's all you need to do. So thank you. I'm going to be off the OT now and would ask Dr. Padma to carry on with her presentation. Thank you for waiting, and we'll get the next case ready.
Thank you, Dr. Kaveri, for the very nice visualization of the ovum pickup.
Awesome.
Thank you very much.
I think discussion was going on, but
yeah.
I'm acutely aware
yeah,
of the
yeah.
trigger
no, no,
time.
No, we were waiting for you.
Okay, okay.
Actually, the screen is not visible right now.
Yeah, the screen, can you show the, is it visible
yeah,
now?
We are seeing it.
Okay, okay.
Right.
So this is a 34-year-old lady with secondary infertility with the tubal block, and she's going for her first round of IVF, again antagonist stimulation with HMG 450 units. And this is her left ovary, and this is how the stimulation is. It's quite a reasonably good stimulation, and I'm going to put my needle in and try to demonstrate what I was, as you see, I'm just slightly pulling the needle till the follicle is completely, and then changing it. Then I puncture the other one. Tube needs to be changed. And once I just do a move in up and down to be sure that the entire follicle is drained, because sometimes in a single plane it may appear drained, but it's actually not drained. So once you're sure that the follicle is emptied, I again take it out, rotate it, and be sure that the follicle is empty, and then move my probe to identify the next follicle. It's very good to have the eco-lucent tip to be sure where you are, and with current needles it makes life very easy.
Dr. Kaveri?
Yes?